Hello guys, welcome back to my channel. So in this video we have the LG G7 ThinQ, and you might be wondering what am I doing with the 2018 flagship in 2020. So there is actually a reason for it. So recently I was looking for a budget smartphone below 10,000 of rate, which had an amazing camera for me to shoot, you know, YouTube videos with that. So I did a lot of research and I found that there is literally no budget phone with a good camera. So finally I came across this phone, the LG G7 ThinQ of the 2018 flagship, and I was really impressed with this camera because I have been a user of LG for many past years now, and after a long time I got the LG back again. So I can say that it has one of the best cameras. Like if you see my 2 to 3 old videos before this, those are all shot on LG G7 ThinQ, this phone. So with that you can clearly see how the camera really is of this phone. Apart from that, this phone has a Qualcomm 845 Snapdragon chipset that is way better than any other budget phone has right now. So this can run any high-end graphic games, and with 4 GB of RAM and 64 GB of internal storage, it is just amazing. So, and recently it has been getting the Android update 10 in India. So I don't know what else can you ask for. I got this phone for about 5,000 rupees on OLX, that is around $100, I think. Not even $100, I think $70. So yeah, I thought it's a very good bargain. Though I cracked the screen very recently because I use it very rough, but still it's giving me the work that I wanted out of it very well. So coming to the screen, it's an IPS LCD screen with 545 PPI of density, and you can see how nice the screen is. It's almost like a 2020 budget phone with very minimal bezels except the bottom chin, and you have a very nice colorful display here. I'll just put some other display here. You can clearly see how well this has been calibrated, the color and all. So yeah, you can see here again. So I've been really liking this phone a lot. It has 4 GB of RAM, 64 GB of internal storage, and it has the amazing boom sound speakers that are very well known for LG phones. So that is again one more pro of it that you will not find any other budget phone. Then it has a tap to wake up and tap to close feature that again is very cool, that was started initially in LG. Then coming to the back, it has a fingerprint scanner that is very quick actually. See, you can see here. I'll just close the phone. Okay, then 1, 2, 3. Yes. Okay, then again 1, 2, 3. It's pretty quick. And again, I have to say this, I really like the back scanner a lot because fingerprint scanners that are coming right now are really very difficult to actually, you know, locate if you're not used to it. But before, in the year 2018, 2017, it was all about back scanner, and mostly budget phones have that now, but we are slowly moving to the fingerprint scanner. That is a on-screen fingerprint scanner. So that is there. And coming to the camera, we have the features like AI cam that will detect what you are going to click, and according to that it will give you the contrast and everything. So you can see this is really nice. Camera quality is something that I really like about this phone. I'll be putting up some camera samples here that you can clearly see, and you'll get to know the real camera qualities. Yeah, so this has some amazing camera features as well and modes. You can see here, this has the Cine video that is actually very useful for making, you know, the YouTube videos and all. When you don't have gimbal, you can just click here, start recording, then you can just zoom it like this and it will give a perfect zoom as if you are going closer to it in a gimbal. So it will not have any shaky hands problem or anything. So that is something that I really liked. And let's see the video how it is. Yeah, so as you can see, it really does the job well, and it comes with a 3000 mAh of battery. It's pretty good actually. It is giving me a day of usage, and I use it very roughly for mostly for camera purposes and also to watch some YouTube videos time to time. And that's all. I don't have any SIM inside this right now, but soon I'll be giving it to my mom mostly for her to use it. And let's listen to some music now and see how the sound quality of this phone is. Here you can see the sound quality of the phone. As you can hear the sound, when you feel this in your hand, it gives a totally different feeling. The haptic feedback is too good in this phone actually. Very nice haptic feedback. And this sound, okay, it's blinking right here like this. Okay, so this has this LED flash thing that you can of course turn it off. So yeah, that's how the sound quality of this phone is. Then coming back to this settings that I found, I have to tell you, this has this hi-fi quad DAC and also DTX 3D surround that is amazing. When you connect it to a Bluetooth device, you must use it to know it, because it just sounds amazing. Then also the phone comes with a 15 watts fast charger for a 2018 flagship. I think this charges the phone really fast, and I think it's a very good addition to the phone. And coming to high quad DAC, earphones, you will use it and you will know the real quality of every beat of the sound. So this phone is totally worth it in the year 2020. If you are looking for a budget smartphone and not thinking of compromising in a camera department or gaming department, and you have a budget to look for, then this phone is to look out for. One of the best budget phones right now, and it recently got the Android 10 update as well. So I think it will not get any further updates, but Android 10, 4GB of RAM, 64GB of Intel memory, 845 Snapdragon, it's I think too good for your 2018 as a budget phone. So yeah, you can definitely have LG.